So, heights and distances. We have a question in which the aeroplane is at an altitude of 900 meters. What do we mean by altitude? Altitude means height. So, an aeroplane is flying at a height of 900 meters from the ground level. Finds that two ships are sailing towards it. So, there are two ships which are sailing towards it, coming towards it. Let these two ships be ship A and ship B, right? In the same direction, right? The angles of depression of the ships as observed from the plane, right? So, from the plane, the angles of depression. So, we always need to have the reference line which is parallel to the ground line for angles of depression. So, we have created that. Now, he is saying that the angles of depression of the ships as observed from the plane are 60 and 30. That means when you look at these ships from the aeroplane, the angles of depression are 60 degree and 30 degree, right? Does that mean this entire angle is 60 degree? That is why this angle is 60 degree. Alternate angles. Similarly, this angle is 30 degree. That is why this angle is 30 degree, right? So, when you look at these two ships, the angles of depression are 60 degree and 30 degree respectively. He wants us to find the distance between the ships. That means this distance we have to calculate. Let this distance be x, and let's call this as c, and let this be d. This distance, let this be y, right? Now, let's take triangle DAC. It's a right angle triangle, and if we take tan 30 degree, what will be the value of tan 30 degree here? Opposite upon adjacent. What is opposite? 900. And what is adjacent? This entire thing. Because in this triangle, this is opposite and this entire thing is adjacent. So, x plus y. Tan 30, as we know, is 1 by root 3 is equal to 900 upon x plus y. Now, if we cross multiply, we will get x plus y is equal to 900 root 3. Let's name this equation as 1. Now, let's go to triangle DCB. In this triangle, tan 60 degree is equal to opposite upon adjacent. Opposite is 900 and adjacent is 1. Now, tan 60 is root 3 is equal to 900 upon y. So, if you shift y here, and bring root 3 here, you are going to get 900 upon root 3, right? So, if we rationalize this, what do we get? We will get 900 root 3 upon 3. Root 3 into root 3 is 3. So, 3 threes are. So, you got the value of y as 300 root 3. Now, you'll go back to this equation and replace the value of y as 300 root 3. So, you are getting x plus 300 root 3 is equal to 900 root 3. So, your x is equal to 900 root 3 minus 300 root 3. How much is that? 600 root 3. Right? So, now, we know the value of this root 3. How much is that? 1.732, right? So, this value may be given sometimes and sometimes it won't. But in the question, it will be written that find the answer to nearest decimals. That means you have to replace this value. So, that means you need to remember the value of this under root 3, right? So, x is equal to, let's multiply. So, 6 twos are. Okay, let's do it like this, 1732 into 600 divided by how many zeros? 1000. So, this and this will go. So, my x is 6 twos are, let me write it here again, 1732 into 6 divided by 10. So my x is equal to 6 2s are 12, 1 carry, 6 3s are 18 and 1 19, 1 carry, 6 7s are 42 and 1 43, 4 carry, 6 1s are 6, 7 8 9 10. And then we have this 10 here. So finally my x is equal to 1039.2 meters. Be very careful when you are doing such calculations, right? Never try to do these calculations in head, because otherwise you will mess up sometimes. Okay.